Hello, I'm George, and you're on Bubble Spark. Welcome to a new segment on this channel called PSTT, or PST. It stands for Bubble Spark Thursday Tip. That's actually a very awful name for a segment, but we'll run with it. So let's get coding. One of the key elements to using infrastructure as code is the ability to achieve an idempotent state of infrastructure resources. What this means is that we only need to apply a particular state of code once and have the infrastructure resources created for us. And if we rerun this code set several times without making any changes to the code, we expect that the result show no actual infrastructure changes to apply. This is pretty much the main source of confidence to changes in your infrastructure. One of many critical infrastructure resources that we set up include security groups, and these resources are the safety traps that we put in place to ensure that only expected traffic flow through a system. It's a firewall infrastructure resource after all. And I have been confronted by unexpected changes in the past with regards to security groups, and for some time, I was puzzled as to why the changes are flagged. So let's get to the code to look into this in more detail. The first thing that we will do is create a very simple security group resource. I am going to create this security group in the default VPC, so I will leave out the VPC ID property just to make this exercise as simple as possible. A security group needs an ingress and an egress property, and so you would naturally embed these properties inside the resource block like this. Suppose I want public access support 80 and 443 to flow through my security group resource. I would add these blocks. And for simplicity, let's say I want traffic to flow out to the public through these same ports. So what I would do is duplicate these ingress blocks. And I will name the two new blocks to egress like so. And now I have a security group resource block that has two ingress rules and two egress rules. And if I go ahead and run with this code for the first time, so let me switch my VS Code terminal. So as usual, I'm going to initialize my AWS credentials. And then I'm going to run Terraform init. And then run Terraform plan. And let's quickly have a look at the output of the plan. So this will create my security group resource, and that looks good. And now I'm going to run Terraform apply to create the actual infrastructure resource. And now I have an initial state of security group resource. If I am not changing anything and run Terraform plan again, the output tells me that nothing has changed, so that all looks good. Now this is where it gets a little bit disturbing. Let me go back to my code. And suppose I want to add a new CIDR block to my ingress rule for port 443. So let's get into that code. So here is my ingress block for port 443, and I'm going to add a new CIDR block. What I have done here is very simple. I just added one new CIDR block for my security group to allow inbound to port 443 for that particular IP address. Now let's go ahead and run Terraform plan against this change. So let me head to my VS Code terminal. Clear this. And then I'm going to run Terraform plan. Now let's expand on this output. The summary output looks good. It says there is one change. I made a change on my security group resource, so that is pretty much expected. But let's have a look at the details of the change. So if I scroll up, this output tells me that when my code change is applied, Terraform will remove all my pre-existing rules and then add them again. But what if this security group is used in, say, a production setting for a critical system, and in the middle of updating the security group, something happened and my old rules have been deleted and have not been reinstated? Okay, I'm exaggerating, but technically there is a slight possibility what I just described could happen, and this output brings down confidence to the change. The good thing is, there is a way to change this to make sure that the output shows a granular set of expected change. So let's head back to my code. And then let me get rid of the new CIDR block for now so we appreciate the difference between the old setup and the new setup. So what I will do now is introduce a new set of resources called security group rule for both set of ingress and egress rules. So what I'm going to do is head to the end of my main.tf and then introduce a new resource block for the first ingress. This resource needs a property called type, which can be either ingress or egress. I am setting this first block to ingress, so let's set that as the type for this block. And then I will set the from port and to port to 80. And then set the protocol property to TCP. And then I will add the CIDR blocks using the same value that I have set in my original block. And lastly, the security group ID, which needs to point to the resource that I need this rule to be attached. In this case, the security group resource is the one that I created earlier. And then I can simply duplicate this code block and then change the name of the resource, change the port that is being accessed, and save my changes. And then I am going to duplicate both resource blocks and change the resource names, and then change the type for both resource blocks to indicate that they are for egress, and then save my changes. And now I need to go back to my original security group resource right at the top of the code, and then get rid of all the embedded ingress and egress blocks inside my security group resource. Which leaves me with just the name property for my AWS Security Group resource. Let me save that change. And now let me switch to my VS Code terminal. So let's clear this. So we need to pretend this is the first time that I'm applying this infrastructure code. So we need to destroy whatever resource that has already been created in AWS. So let me run Terraform plan -destroy. So let's have a look at the output. So that's pretty much the security group that I just created. So let's run Terraform apply. Now, let's run Terraform plan again. Let's review the output. It will create 5 new resources, which is what I expect. 1 for the main security group resource and 4 security group rules. So let me go ahead and apply this change. So all my 5 new resources are now created. Now, the rule of idempotent says that if I run Terraform plan again without making code changes, the result should tell me nothing will be changed in the infrastructure. So let's run Terraform plan again. So that looks good. No infrastructure changes are going to be applied. Now, let's go back to my code and then implement the same change that we did earlier. So on the ingress resource rule for port 443, which is right here, I'm going to add another CIDR block in the list. And then head to my VS Code terminal and run Terraform plan. The result of the run now tells me that a new resource will be destroyed and a new one will be created. So let's have a look at the output of the run. This result looks better than what we saw earlier, where some rules are being deleted and recreated back into the security group. But this result is not ideal either, because it destroys the existing rule for a particular port. So let's get back to my code and fix this. Based on the output of the run, I now know that changes to the CIDR blocks property will result to my resource being replaced. So in order to fix this, I will need to create a separate resource for each CIDR block. And to achieve this, I will need to add a new property called for each inside my resource rule. So let's get into that. So this is my port 443 rule. I'm going to add a for each property. And then I will let Terraform look through a list of CIDR blocks that I want my security group rule resource to be created for. So what I'm going to do is, I will move the value of the starter blocks property into this new for each property and make sure to convert the list to a set. And then I will plug in the value of each element of the set into the cider blocks property of the resource, like so. For now, I am going to get rid of the new cider block in the list. And now I'm going to switch to my VS Code terminal and run Terraform plan. The result tells me that one resource will be destroyed and a new one will be created, and I'm expecting this. So let's have a look at the output. This output is a result of changing the type of the resource from a flat resource reference to a list, and this is made obvious by the name of the resource that will be created or destroyed due to the code change. So you will notice the name here, which is a flat resource name, whereas the resource that is going to be created has an index using the cider block value of the list. So let's go ahead and apply this change. And now that the change is applied, let me go back to my code. And this time, I'm going to update the list with the new cider block. Now let me head back to my VS Code terminal, run Terraform plan, and now the summary result tells me that one resource will be added, which is exactly what I wanted to see with the run. So if I expand this output, now that looks even better. The output is now showing me the infrastructure change that I expect to happen as a result of my code change. I have more confidence applying this change because I know that the other rules are not going to be affected. There are no rules that are going to be deleted in the process, but there is one rule that will be created, which is what I expect to happen anyways. That's it. I think this approach is a lot cleaner and brings more confidence to infrastructure code changes. But let me know what you think in the comments below, and send me some likes if you find this useful. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like the content on this channel. Until next time, keep learning and stay safe. See ya.